Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPGle sample video. In other videos I've already talked about service programs. You already know that a service program is just an object that contains a number of procedures or functions which, for example, are made in RPGle but can be made in other language and which are completely independent. We are used to call them from other programs inside the IBMI. But yes, it is also possible to use them using SQL, and also they can be used from other environments, just putting them inside an SQL function or procedure. And that, of course, allows us to reuse our code since the same query or function can be used from the IBMI or from outside. Today, I'd like to talk about SQL functions and procedures, which, as you know, can also be called stored procedures. Of course, these procedures and functions can call RPGle procedures of a service program, and that is what I'm going to show you today. Let's go. I'd like to start by showing you a small service program that I have, which contains a series of procedures and functions. They are written in RPGle, but as I told you at the beginning of the video, they could be written in COBOL or in C, for example. The main and only module of this service program is this. Let me open it. This one. Okay. Well, I'm going to work with these two first procedures, this one and this one. As you see, the second, this one procedure, has three parameters. The first two are input and the third is input and output. The first procedure, this one, can also call a function because it is returning a value. So I have two input parameters and a return value. Okay? They both do the same. Well, I already have the service program compiled on my IBMI, and therefore I can use it in other programs to call any of the functions it contains and that are exportable. This one and this one. Okay? And there's others. Okay? Well, let's make a stored procedure. The stored procedure or SQL procedure, as you know, can be written in SQL, but they can also call programs or, as in this case, procedures written in other languages, such as RPGle. As I mentioned before, I have a procedure and a function. Let's say that the function is the one that returns a value. Well, let's create an SQL procedure and also an SQL function. The first will call sum A and B2, this one, and the second will call to this one, sum A and B. Okay, so let's go to our friend Run SQL Scripts Utility. Okay, let's create the procedure using create procedure. This is the way. Create procedure. Well, let's create or replace sum A and B two, okay, because I'm going to call to the second procedure. Now I write the parameters. The first parameter is an input parameter and it's going to be called A, and it's this type. I have a second parameter, B. And I have a third parameter that is an output parameter, okay? And we close this. Okay, now I have to write here the external name, that is the name of the program, or in this case, the name of the procedure inside a service program, okay? We have to put this in caps, okay? This way. And now we have to write here the language, that is RPGle, deterministic. This is because in this case this procedure is going to return the same in this parameter, in the output parameter, it is going to return always the same for the same input parameters. Okay, if not, it should be we should write here non-deterministic. Okay, well, and parameter style general. Okay, well, this way we can write, we can create a procedure. Okay, this way. So let me run it. Okay, we have a, we have created it, and now let me create an SQL function using the create function statement. Okay, which does the same thing but calling to the other RPGle procedure. Okay, let me write it, create or replace, in this case function some a and b1 in this case. And now we have two parameters that are a and b. In this case, we don't need to write here if they are input or output, because in a function we have all the parameters are input parameters. Okay, and we have a return value that is written this way. Now we have to write here the external name as in the other case. Language, same. This is the same also. And this. Okay, and let me run it. Okay. Now let's check that our procedure works. Okay, well, to do that, we're going to define a variable and we will pass two values and the variable in which the procedure will return the result. Okay, so let me write here create or replace variable C. Okay. Okay, now let me set the value to 0. It is not necessary, but well. And now we are going to call to sum a and b2. With three parameters, okay? For example, 1, 5, and now the variable. So if I run it, and if I want to see the value, the content of the C value, parameter, the third parameter, we can write here this, and this is what I get, 6. And 6 is the same as 1 plus 5, so it is running okay. Well, now we do the same with this function, but in this case it is not necessary to define variables. We can use select to get the result this way. Select A and B1, and I write here 1 and 6, for example, from this. Okay, and if I run it, oh, there's something wrong. Let me see. I have to change this. Okay, let me run it. And if I run it now, this is what I'm getting. 1 and 6. Okay, that is 7. Well, as you can see, it works correctly. Well, can we use this from an RPG program? Yes, of course. And in fact, we can use both the procedure and the function. Well, I have prepared an example where you can see how to use it. Let me show it to you. Close this. We're going to open it. This one. Well, as you can see, here I have the call to the procedure, as in the ACS, which is nothing more than a call using exec SQL. And in the case of the function, we can use the same way as in the ACS. We can use select, okay? Or we could also assign its value with set this way, okay? Well, let me compile the program. And let's go to the green screen to check how it works. Okay, let me start a debug session. Now let's stop the program here and let's run it. And as you can see, when I'm calling to the sum A and B2 procedure, what I'm getting in the sum variable is 6. So it works correctly. And also, if I'm doing a set with the function, what I'm getting with in sum is 5, that is 2 plus 3. This is the same as if I do a select, because I'm getting the same value. Okay, well, as you can see, this is a simple and very useful way to encapsulate functions that we are going to use from other RPG programs or from other language made programs, but also from programs that run outside our IBMi environment, for example from .NET, PHP, or any other environment, who need to obtain information from the database but without having to query it directly. I think it is also a good way to reuse code. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.